Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad, and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंदगंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
The next technical term in this verse, internal organ of perception. I just started defining few words. Emotion, the energy which gets converted as excitement and makes the motion happen in you is emotion. Joy, the small vacation you give for yourself after continuous natural torture you do to yourself. Pain, the payment you give for being in is pain. First, like when you learn any subject, how you are given a dictionary. When you learn English, you are given English dictionary. When you learn Tamil, you are given a Tamil dictionary. when you learn Sanskrit. You are given a Sanskrit dictionary. Same way, when you learn life, you should be given life dictionary. Where is life dictionary? Internal organ of perception is the spark came out of your life source, making organs alive and perceive, process information. Understand this example. A heap of rice after digestion. A fly is continuously sitting between these two. The rice after digestion is your organs. The heap of rice is your self, means the cosmic self, life source. This bee which is moving continuously makes this heap of rice after digestion feel it has life. That is internal organ of perception. Because this fly is moving so fast between these two, this heap also starts feeling, I am also alive. I am also being eaten by somebody. But actually that heap is not being eaten by the bee. Heap is getting spoiled by the bee constantly sitting here after sitting there. If continuously it is sitting here, there, what happened? Whatever is stuck in his leg, it will come here. After 100 times, this whole heap of rice will look little yellowish. Now, unless visually I describe, how will you understand? That bee is internal organ of perception. What we call chakshu, when it sits on the eyes. We call it shrotra, when it sits on the ears. We call it grana, when it sits on the nose. We call it sparsha, when the bee sits on the touch. Chakshu, shrotra, jihva. We call it jihva, when it sits on the mouth. That is internal organ of perception. And the intelligence, this is a key term. Intelligence is constantly remembering the internal organ of perception does not have individual existence even though it claims to be having, is intelligence. Knowing that the feeling of your doership is not a solid experience, it is a simple, when you know this, you will always carry the light mood in the life. The energy circuit. That energy circuit gets alive when your whole body laughs, when you are just laughing. The fellows who are laughing around will not be fooling around. If you are fooling around, you will not be able to be laughing around. Intelligence is the non-trust on the internal organ of perception. Not trusting the internal organ of perception as the ultimate minister, advisor, counselor. Not trusting the advice, counseling given to you by the internal organ of perception as ultimate is intelligence. Now, I have given you the definition of all the three technical terms. Understand the sacred secret from this verse. Sense organs, the internal organ of perception, and the intelligence are said to be the seat of this insatiable, all-consuming desire. Even though intelligence does not take the internal organ of perception as the ultimate authority, still it has a little bit of hangover with the internal organ of perception. These three are the foundation on which all these insatiable desires, all-consuming desire pattern, I am not enough, is built. The embodied being, poor you, with his understanding leading to repetition of birth and death is bewildered. When you have the understanding, the internal organ of perception has more power than perceiving, your doership, the false doership as a real individuality, when you believe that, you are led to the repetition of birth and death and bewildered. What is bewildered?
Eliminate stress from your life. Step up your performance levels. Enhance your clarity and decision making. Kalpataru, a unique full-day transformational healing program blessed personally by rare living incarnation Paramahamsa Nityananda. Harness the power of meditation and initiation. Experience a glimpse of Kundalini awakening for permanent physical and mental transformation. Take the first step to a happy and successful life. Kalpataru, manifest your destiny. Every weekend at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru.
Astvayudhaya na tathaya drishnave ubha बने परिधे धन्वनो हेदिरस्मान् दृढक्तो विश्वतः अजो यदि शुधिस्तपारे अस्मन्निदेहितम् नमस्ते अस्तु भगवन् विश्वेश्वराय महादेवाय त्र्यम्बकाय त्रिपुरान्तकाय त्रिकाग्निकालाय कालाग्निरुद्राय नीलकाय मृत्युञ्जयाय सर्वेश्वराय सदा शिवाय शङ्कराय श्रीमन्महादेवाय नमः नमो हिरण्यवाघवे सेनान्येति शाञ्च पदये नमो नमो वृक्षेभ्यो हरिकेशेभ्यः पशूनां पदये नमो नमः सस्मिञ्जराय त्रिशीमदेवतीनां पदये नमो नमो बभ्लुषाय विव्याधिनेन्नानां पदये
When you are caught red-handed By the structuring, how you feel, that is bewildered. Your life is nothing but catch the sacred secret. Life with so many times being bewildered is not worth living. Hate it. Come out of it. I'm not saying commit suicide. No. Raise yourself to the next level. Come out of it. Raise yourself to the highest responsibility. Then anything I say is like a water poured on the inverted pot. Whether it is a water or milk or even nectar poured on the inverted pot, the pot is neither going to hold nor going to taste. It's only going down the drain. Untouched by anything which awakens them. Only I call them as old people. Old enough to feel they are old or old people. Body can never become old and should never become old. Body should be alive and young as long as it is breathing. Even after breathing 3 months, you can't become old. The ash is allowed to become old after 3 months, not before that. The Siddhas, their body, hair and nail grows even up to 6 months. Normal man's body, 27 days it grows. Hair and nails. For Siddhas, even after 6 months. Understand. Till your death, you are not allowed to get aged. Aging means feeling bewildered, seeing the life. We have 3 categories young people. Young but tired. Young but retired. Young but dead. For young and tired, Annapurani spoon is enough to give life. Young and retired, master's tongue, the tip of the master's tongue, initiation, is enough to get them out. But young and dead, only Kalbhairava's Trishul tip is the only way to make them alive. Varanasi has all 3. So young and tired, young and retired, young and dead. For all 3 people, medicine is in Varanasi.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nithyananda. Nithyananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher-order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social-emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting, and design offered in the Ingenious program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of all abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings. First thing required for optimum health is oxygen. Your body is made up of trillions of cells. Each one of them requires steady flow of oxygen. Oxygen is so important. Even if few seconds of disturbance in oxygen supply, a few seconds in oxygen supply to cells can cause diseases. If it is few minutes, it can cause death itself. Let me give you a clear vision of this word optimum health. Optimum health means body not only functioning perfectly, the possibility of the diseases happening should not be there. That's what I call optimum health. Every cell needs steady flow of oxygen. Unfortunately, most of us, even though we are breathing, we don't take the oxygen completely. Oxygen supply to each cell is such an important necessity. Not only we don't supply enough oxygen to trillions of our cells in the body, we go on disturbing it. The Siddha tradition, there is a beautiful description. Every time you visualize certain negative idea in your system, for example, if you are visualizing an accident, one part of your body does not get oxygen supply. The moment you create stressful, negative thought, immediately the system responds to it and the oxygen supply to many parts of your body drastically gets reduced. In Vedic tradition, we go beyond oxygen, one step beyond oxygen. We call it prana. Prana is the food for the mitochondria in your cell. See, oxygen is necessary for cell, but for mitochondria, the subtle part of oxygen, which we call as prana, is required. That is why when you do pranayama or when your kundalini energy is awakened by initiation, your mitochondria cell energy goes so high, automatically you start experiencing optimum health and anti-aging. Breathing is a basic thing required for health. Just if you start breathing consciously, if breathing, proper breathing is taught, thousands of diseases in the planet Earth will disappear. So many of your diseases can disappear just by properly breathing. Human beings need basic training for breathing. But unfortunately, the pharmaceutical industries and the fast food industries do not like this kind of good things spreading all over the world. That is why they go on trying to create doubt about the pranayama and breathing techniques. This whole enkriya is based on breathing. How your whole body can be supplied with intense prana, the subtle part of oxygen. How not only your mitochondria cell energy, your very DNA can be awakened, made to live through proper breathing. Understand? I'll tell you exactly how it feels. modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis. I have created a 1-year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya yoga practices to create healthy body, spiritual discourses to develop mental health, meditations that help balance emotions, kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering, opportunity to express leadership qualities, techniques that improve creative skills, learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru. 9742203311.
Living in the fully alive body. See, if you are one layer of diamond, for example, I am describing your body is made out of one layer of diamond, and the diamond is shining. My body is made out of 7 layer of diamonds. All 7 layer is shining. How it will feel? Your body is also made out of 7 layer of diamonds. Unfortunately, only one layer is cut diamond. Unfortunately, the deeper layers of the diamond is not polished. You don't need to be a spiritual person. You don't need to believe all the spiritual ideas, follow aparigraha, celibacy and all other spiritual truths, nothing. Just do breathing, proper conscious breathing. The diamonds inside your next 6 layers can be awakened. You just live in 1G. By the time you come to 2G, you see, oh, and you grab and do corruption. Get caught. Come on. There is 7G. I was studying about the spectrum. In 1G, what kind of things get transmitted? In 2G, what all is possible? Now the 3G phones have come already. The video calls. Your very spectrum can be raised just by breathing. Proper breathing. If the prana is infused into your system, I can say greatest secret for enlightenment, you don't need to do anything except working on your breath. You can eat whatever you want. You can drink whatever you want. You can live the way you want. You don't need to change your lifestyle. If you can work on breathing solidly, properly, you don't need any of the yama, niyama, nothing, asana, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, nothing is required. The whole secret is in breathing, oxygen and prana. Maybe when more prana is infused into your system, there may be some discipline you will start following, but infusing prana into your system is the most sacred secret for the optimum health, for your physical, mental well-being, and for enlightenment itself. Usually I can't create any thought in my system. So I study some of the disciples. When they get certain thought, what kind of oxygen flow is happening in them? What kind of prana is flowing in them? How much of prana gets stored in mitochondria cell? How their system becomes alive, energetic, intelligent? Just proper breathing. When I say proper, this N kriya is more than enough. Doing N kriya twice a day can heal thousands of diseases. Many diseases related to prana can be completely cured. Just proper breathing does so much. Unfortunately, ordinary human beings feel they are living in too many minds at a time. The difference between hell and heaven is too many bodies, one mind, sometimes not even there, that even that is not there. This is heaven. Too many minds, only one body. Sometimes even that one body is not proper. It is broken and sick. Sick and broke, one body, too many minds, active, violent is hell. Too many bodies, one mind that is also not much active, almost relaxing, having vacation, is heaven. In Indian villages, when the girls are given in marriage, they will give a special kind of a vessel. One in one, it can get fixed. They will put some, even 10 vessels, one will go in, another one will go in, another one will go in, another one will go in, another. 10 vessels will be inside one vessel. How? If you think it's one vessel and try to lift it, you can't, because 10 vessels is inside. Same way, I am feeling it's not one body. It's layers and layers and layers. Some 7 bodies are there inside. And all 7 are alive. How healthy you will feel, understand? I tell you, do not live just with one body. Live with many bodies. That is optimum health. The problem is, many times you get stuck and satisfied with 1G or 2G. You feel, oh God, in 2G itself we can swindle so much. Then why to go to 3G? I tell you, no, don't stop. Go to 7G, but don't swindle. Raise your spectrum to 7G. Means raise the number of bodies you are having. This proper breathing is one of the most powerful methods for optimum health.